Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Ignite Kids Does Sunday. Let's get ready for more boot camp fun.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the main event. Let's get ready to rumble!
Y'all ready for this? Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Ignite Kids Does Sunday. I hope you're having a great weekend, and I'm looking forward to the things that we're going to have and do today at Ignite on Sunday. So we're carrying on with our bootcamp theme, and today's subject is garbage in, garbage out. I wonder, what does that mean? Garbage. Garbage is another word for rubbish. Okay, so it's kind of like an American way of saying rubbish. So if we put rubbish in, then all we're going to get is rubbish out. And that's what we're thinking about today. So what are we thinking about? What are we learning about? What are we putting in our bodies? And we're thinking about just doing good things and putting good things in our bodies and putting good things in our minds. So that's what we're going to do today. We've got our Taskmaster, or should I call it Duckmaster Challenge, a little bit later on as well. See what Robin and I are going to be getting up to, as well as our story. But first, we need to do some singing. So I thought today we would do... Okay, so we're going to do stand strong. So let's stand up and let's sing.
Again, I found out the word. Do you know what it is?
I don't know the word.
No, it's garbage in, garbage out.
That's four words.
Okay, do you know the four words? Garbage in, garbage out.
Garbage in, garbage out. What does that mean?
It means what we put into our bodies and our minds is what comes out. So if we watch not very nice TV shows,
yeah,
we might not act very nice to our friends.
Okay.
Do you have any ideas of things when you might have eaten or watched or done something?
Where?
Oh.
Funny you should ask, Robin, but if I eat garlic
Ooh.
Or onions, The garbage that I put in makes something really not very nice come out.
Do you feel unwell?
I do feel unwell.
Oh dear.
It makes my tummy feel all yucky.
Ugh.
And sometimes it makes me pump.
Not very nice.
I know.
No.
So I do actually quite agree with the what you put in your body can actually affect
and what we put in our minds.
Yeah.
Do you know a story about that?
I do know a story about that.
Oh, perfect.
It's a story about a family.
Okay.
A family. So there was once, this story was told by Jesus. Okay.
Okay.
So it was one of Jesus' stories. And there was once a farmer and he had two sons, an older son and a younger son. Now the older son, he loved to work on the farm and he would work really, really hard. But the younger son, he did not like working on the farm and he was very, very lazy. And he would lie about in his room all day, just doing nothing.
Well, that's not very helpful, is it?
Not very helpful. Now the younger son had an idea. I can leave the farm, he thinks to himself.
Oh.
But then he thinks, oh, but I can't afford it because I haven't got enough money.
Because he's not working.
But then he thought to himself, if I ask my dad for my share of his money, then I'm sure he'll give it to me and then I'll be able to go away. So that's what he did. He says to his dad, Dad, look, I don't like farming. I want to move away. Can I have my share of your money so that I can go and I can just live my own life?
He by himself.
So the father was really sad about this, but he said, yeah, all right, then you can go and you can have this money and go and make a life for yourself in the city. So off the young boy goes, leaving the older one continuing to work on the farm.
Really?
All right. He's a good boy.
Doesn't feel very fair.
Feel very fair.
Okay.
So he gets to the city and he starts to go to loads of parties.
Oh.
And he buys big, lovely clothes and big houses and all of this stuff. And he's got loads and loads and loads and loads and loads and loads of friends. And he's buying them food and stuff. And he's just having a great time.
One big party.
And you'd think that was really good for him.
He would have loved it.
But actually, it was really bad for him. Because what happened was, not only was he making himself unhealthy by eating all of the wrong stuff, but he was running out of money.
Oh, dear.
And eventually, he had none left. He spent it all on friends and parties. And so he had nothing left. And everybody, all of his friends, disappeared.
Well, not real friends then, are they?
As soon as he ran out of money.
Oh, so he was on his own again and no money.
On his own again and no money. Garbage in, garbage out. But he thought to himself, right, I'm going to have to get a job now. So he goes and he finds a job on a pig farm.
Ugh.
And it was really smelly and stinky. And he was so hungry, he even ate the pig food and it was disgusting.
Oh, awful.
And he thought to himself, do you know what? The servants in my dad's house have got better quality of life than I've got. I'm going to go back and I'm going to say sorry to him. So he makes up his mind and he leaves and he says goodbye to the pig farmer and off he goes home. To see his dad, and he's rehearsing in his head, sorry, and he's trying to work out what he's going to say to his dad. And his dad sees him coming in the distance, and you'd think his dad was going to be mad.
I think he'd be mad and upset.
He didn't. He ran out to greet him like this, and he flung his arms around him, even though he was still smelling a pig. And he says, welcome home, my son. Let's go and have a party for you to welcome you. And his son said, yeah, but I don't deserve a party. I've done really bad stuff and I spent all your money and I just want to come back and I want to work on the farm again.
Mm-hmm.
But you see, the father, he wraps his arms around him and says, no, come on, we're going to celebrate you coming home.
Yeah.
And that's the thing, you see, sometimes we do things that are wrong, the garbage, the rubbish in our lives.
Mm-hmm.
But when we say sorry, we can make it all right again.
Yeah.
And you see, in this case, Jesus was talking about God. When we do something wrong or we mess up and have all this rubbish in our lives, we can say to God, God, we're really, really sorry. Will you help us not to do that again?
And luckily we're back, like nothing was ever wrong.
Yeah, and you're clean again.
That's amazing.
Did you know, Robin, that the boys and girls watching might not realise that they can be friends with Jesus?
Oh, but everybody can be friends with Jesus.
Everybody can be friends with Jesus. So I think we should do a really special prayer today.
Okay.
Are you going to help me do it?
I'm going to help you.
If I pray it, you can repeat after me.
Okay.
Because the boys and girls can do your part.
Okay.
And I'll do...
I'll be the boys and girls.
You can be the boys and girls. So what's going to happen, boys and girls? If you want Jesus to be your very, very special friend, you say the words with Robin. So I'm going to say the words and then Robin's going to repeat them. Okay? Shall we pray?
Let's pray.
Fantastic. Dear Lord Jesus.
Dear Lord Jesus.
I believe in you.
I believe in you.
I thank you for dying for me.
I thank you for dying for me.
I pray that you will forgive me.
I pray that you will forgive me.
And allow me to be part of your family.
And allow me to be part of your family.
Come into my life today.
Come into my life today.
And for the rest of my days.
And for the rest of my days.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, if you prayed that prayer with Robin and I, go and tell somebody now. Now this minute. Don't even wait for the next thing on the screen. Just run in and say, Mom and Dad, I've just asked Jesus to be my friend. Because that's the best news that you can tell anybody. And if you want to, please let us know, because we would love to celebrate with you. Just like the dad celebrated with his son. And that is brilliant news.
Amazing news.
Okay, we'll see you next week. You take care. Bye. Okay, good morning everybody, and welcome to what we like to call Duckmaster. The reason being is we've been using a lot of ducks in these challenges, and today it looks like we've got another duck to use. So let's have a little look and see what duck kind of challenge we have to do today. Okay, right, so we've each got a duck each, and we've got to spin the duck for the longer, so we'll do it at the same time. We'll spin the duck. Whoever's is still going is the winner. That's it really, isn't it?
Yeah, we can do this one.
Okay, right, so the key is, though, to get them both spinning at the same time.
Yes.
Right, so ready, steady, go.
Mine
first.
Mine
needs
to win.
Right, okay.
Pasta.
Ready, steady, go.
Come on. You're still going. Shocking. Yay!
Shocking. I want a recount.
No, I won.
What's wrong with you? Okay, have a go. It was weird. It kind of worked.
That's an easy one for us for a change.
A nice easy one for us for a day. And we'll see you next time. Bye. Okay, everybody, that's nearly time for us to say goodbye for today. I hope you've enjoyed what we've done today for you, and I pray that you've had a great weekend. Okay, so just a few little notices. So tomorrow night, Ignite Life Group, 6:30 as usual. Come along and we'll have some fun there. On Friday, Ignite Extra, come along 6:30, bring your friends to that one. Do you know what? We are growing. We are growing and growing. I've had to put more X's on the floor. So come along on Friday night and have some fun. 20 pence for tax shop. Don't forget to bring your water bottle so that you can slurp as much as you want, and then you don't have to wait for us to get drinks out. Other than that, we're back as normal next week as well. So let's finish off with a prayer. So let's wiggle our fingers. Here we go. Wiggle, 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 wiggle. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Lord God, we thank you so much for all the fun that we've had today, for everything we've learned about as well. God, help us to only put good things in our bodies. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Okay, boys and girls, we'll see you next week. Have a great week at school. Bye.